Feast your eyes on the revised 2021 Lexus IS. Lexus Ubiquitous Sports Sedan has received some key updates for the 2021 model year. The brand hopes will make it a more stout competitor against the BMW 3 Series and Mercedes C-Classes of the world. But is it enough? Well, let's find out. You can spot the new IS out of a crowd based on the front end. Check out these really aggressive, squinty headlights, which wrap around the Lexus spindle grille, which on this F-Sport trim is painted gloss black and looks really sharp against this ultrasonic blue Mica 2.0 paint job. The IS visual aggression continues in the side profile. Again, with this F-Sport model, you get the upgraded 19-inch matte black wheels, which really fill out the wheel wells and look nice and aggressive. Equally aggressive, sorry, I keep abusing that word, is the roofline on this revised IS. It's really sharp and angular, and there are these huge hips that are so pronounced. This thing makes a BMW 340i look tame by comparison. All of that rolls into a rear end that, again, I just find very visually appealing. With the F-Sport option, you have this carbon fiber trunk spoiler, which looks really nice. And check out these taillights. While they do have a monobrow effect with this middle piece, they're tinted black. And so when you see them and when the sun hits them just right, they look so cool and so futuristic. It also helps this car has a blacked out diffuser element down here, which just, again, spices things up and makes this thing look really interesting on the road. When it comes to picking which flavor of IS you'd like to buy, there's an IS300 and an IS350. So naturally you think there'd be two engine options, but you'd actually be wrong. There are three. In what can only be described as the weirdest marketing choice possible, if you buy a Lexus IS300 with rear-wheel drive as standard, you get a 2-liter turbocharged 4-cylinder good for 241 horsepower. However, if you buy an IS300 with all-wheel drive, inexplicably, that means you now get a 3.5-liter V6 good for 260 horsepower. However, if you buy the full-bore IS350 F-Sport, you also get a 3.5-liter V6, but this one kicks out a massive 311 horsepower. But wait, there's more to the equation than that. If you opt for a rear-wheel drive Lexus IS as standard, you get an 8-speed automatic transmission. However, if you pay the optional $2,000 to get all-wheel drive in your Lexus IS, you just get a 6-speed automatic transmission. At $44,000 as tested, the interior of the IS350 feels well equipped. What looks like leather at first glance is actually Nulux synthetic leather, and I'm a huge fan of this material. It's soft, it's padded, it's cushiony, and it feels really nice to sit in these sport bucket seats. Additionally, speaking of the seats, heated and ventilated front seats are standard on this F-Sport trim. Unfortunately, no heated seats or anything in the back, but hey, at least we're sitting up here. And while you're sitting in the front seats, you're gonna notice some other F-Sport goodies, like this two-tone ash and leather steering wheel with these cool shift paddles for your 8-speed transmission. But more than that, I suspect consumers are gonna notice the new infotainment screen here. This is a 10.3-inch screen derived from the system first seen in the Lexus LS luxury sedan, and actually, it's quite nice. Now, Lexus has gotten a lot of flack over the years for their infotainment system feeling very dated. You have to use this trackpad down here to control what's happening on the screen. However, with this latest revised interface and the larger screen, it's the best implementation yet. Is it as good as Audi MMI? Well, no, but it works much better. And last but certainly not least, don't forget the obligatory Mark Levinson audio. Long a hallmark trait of the Lexus brand, it sounds just as good in the IS as it does any other Lexus model. There isn't too much happening in the back seat of the Lexus IS, but it is worth noting that with the driver's seat in my seating position, I'm 6'1". I do have enough knee room and enough headroom, if only just. But otherwise, there isn't too much going on back here. Sure, there are these same ash trim door inserts you see on the steering wheel, but otherwise, that's kind of it. Trunk space with the IS does seem very reasonable. There's enough room in here to fit two large pieces of luggage for that weekend getaway, should you want to do it. While I am definitely won over by the curbside appeal of the revised Lexus IS, I'm a little bit less sure about this driving experience. Now, sure, this thing on paper has the chops to handle a winding road with ease. After all, this F-Sport model has adaptive variable suspension, which you can toggle between more comfort-oriented and more sporty driving modes, which should work pretty well. Now, the thing giving me pause with the IS350 is actually the powertrain. While this is the most powerful IS variant, and it certainly is not hurting for power anyway with 311 horsepower. It just doesn't necessarily feel quite as nice as what you get with the European competition. I mean, take that BMW 340i I mentioned previously at the beginning of this video. That has a turbocharged six-cylinder engine. It just feels so much more responsive and creamy smooth, while also offering, at least in my opinion, a nicer noise. Now, that's not to say Lexus has not tried with the IS 350. This F-Sport model has an F-Sport cold air intake and an F-Sport exhaust system. But it's just my opinion that as smooth as this V6 engine is, it's just not necessarily as rewarding a sound as some of its Germanic competition. Though that could be subjective on my part. What's less subjective is the transmission tuning. The 8-speed automatic transmission in this car, it's fine. But again, when you compare it to what the Germans are doing, this does just feel a step behind the near telepathic 8-speed automatic transmission you find in the BMW. Now, on the upsides for the IS, however, is definitely the way this thing does in fact handle a winding road. I know I mentioned that adaptive suspension a little while ago, but it really does pay dividends in the IS. Even in the most aggressive Sport Sharp Plus mode, it handles these bumps and this broken pavement really well, even with these 19-inch wheels and their very thin tires. But speaking of those tires, it's worth noting that those are no ordinary rubber. Those are 140 treadwear Bridgestone summer tires, size 235 in the front and 265 out back. So this thing has plenty of grip. In fact, as I dice through this winding road with the IS, I'm inclined to forgive a lot about that powertrain that I'm not a huge fan of, because compared to the Germans, this thing is positively cheap. It's such a great value. I mean, a fully loaded IS 350 is around 47 grand, and as is the way with all German cars, you can totally option up a BMW 3 Series into six digits if you wanted to. So the value this thing represents, while being a solid drive, is definitely commendable on Lexus' part. But what about for the buyers who aren't interested in the most sporty variant of the IS? Well, again, the math just makes sense. Even base price versus base price, the Lexus IS 300 undercuts the price of any Audi A4, BMW 3 Series, or Mercedes C-Class. It undercuts the Audi by a couple hundred bucks. It undercuts the BMW or the Merc by over $2,000. That's a huge savings. Now, I know I've mentioned its German rivals, but let's talk about them more for a little bit. So let's say you are cross-shopping your IS 350 with an Audi A4, BMW 3 Series, or Mercedes C-Class. What are you gonna get for your money? Well, in Audi land, you're looking at the Audi A4 45 TFSI. Now, that jumble of letters and numbers basically means you'll be getting a 2-liter turbocharged 4-cylinder engine that is slightly less powerful than this, but a little bit more fuel efficient. Of course, being an Audi all-wheel drive will be standard versus this being rear-wheel drive with optional all-wheel drive. Now, I know I mentioned it previously, but if you're looking at the BMW, you'll be looking at an M340i, which has a more powerful turbocharged inline six-cylinder engine. Now, I prefer that powertrain to the one in this, but I can absolutely understand that for the price differential, this is a much better value. Pricing with the Mercedes is a little bit more complicated because there are so many more engine options and choices available for that model, but a C300 comparable to this will have also, like the Audi, have a 2-liter turbocharged 4-cylinder engine and return better fuel economy but be less potent in acceleration and, in my opinion, feel a bit less refined. With this revised 2021 IS, Lexus has really done quite a lot to make this thing more attractive to buyers, both visually and in terms of substance. The fact that it does finally have the inclusion of features like Android Auto and Apple CarPlay is definitely a benefit, as is the addition of performance goodies like this F-Sport package. The way it's configured, it's a great driving car. So if after watching this video you are now interested in the new Lexus IS, well, I don't blame you. These 2021 models are arriving on dealership lots across the country in the month of October. But if you want to get more information ahead of time, click the link in the description down below or go to autobuytel.com.